The recording is in progress.
Thank you very much. I'd like to greet everybody. Greetings and welcome to this wonderful day, International Day of Living Together in Peace, organized by the World Humanitarian Organization for Peace and Equity. In short, we call ourselves HOPE. I am Princess Tepi, greeting you from South Africa. And in case you are wondering where South Africa is, it is already just there in the southern part of Africa. So what I would like to do, just to show me that you can hear me, is write in the chat and let me know where are you connecting from. Just nothing long, nothing much. Just to say hi from Philippines, hi from Canada, hi from, you know, just let me know where you are. And we appreciate you for making time to be with us today. I would like to just maybe spell out the house rules. I will be the moderator today, or the chairperson, if you will. So what I usually do is every speaker will have a 10 minutes. When you have run out of your time, I usually just come on screen just to show you. So always please have your eyes on the screen, even when you are reading on your notes, but have your eyes on the screen so that I don't interrupt. But know your time, or you can time yourself. But otherwise, because we are here at the Organization of Peace and the Day of Peace, I always like to do things peacefully. And if we can just have that respect of time. So we will work very well together. I know we are already going to be working very well together. I'm part of the board members of HOPE, and we have been together on this journey under the leadership of our chaplain, our president, James Obatunbi, who is in Nigeria. I would like to give him this opportunity before I go any further, as our president, to really welcome us and let us know that we are home, that we can do as he has already sent us to do, because we all are submitting under his leadership. And then if you can greet us, please, my president. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Honorable Princess Isu Anesebi. I must say thank you for everyone that is joining us in this program, the International Day for Living Together in Peace. And that is what we stand for in World Humanitarian Organization for Peace and Equity, to ensure peace in our society, in our community, and the world at large. My name is James Mercy Obatumibi. I am the CEO of World Humanitarian Organization for Peace and Equity. And I'm having with us here as well most of our board members, like His Highness Honorable Andrew Williams Jr., who has been with us for long year, couple of years now. And he has really been supporting us when it comes to promotion of peace all over the world. And that's why we are having him on board, and all other participants. Here as well, I have Ambassador Lloyd Evratti. He has been always with us too. I appreciate you for coming. I so much appreciate you. And some of our other participants from all over the world, I congratulate you for joining us in this program. I will still Rusli, thank you for coming. Ms. Gai, thank you for coming. Then I must commend the other participant that is joining us from Philippians, Virginia. Thank you so much for joining us in this program. I have to say very big thank you to our moderators, Chaplain Josephine Ekudembo from Nigeria, and as well, the honorable moderator too from South Africa, Israel Anesefi. Thank you, Marcella from Italy, for joining us in this program. And that is what we are cut out for, to promote peace, to live together in peace. We have just come from various countries, we have just come from various communities, we have just come from various ethnic groups, from various races, but we are here together to promote peace. And this is what we should stand for wherever we are in the world. with one voice that peace must reign in our land, and we should be able to tolerate ourselves. We should be able to tolerate ourselves, whatever the situation, whatever the condition, and we must respect individuals' rights. It will make peace to reign, because once we infringe over somebody's right, that is when war or problem comes in. But if we respect ourselves and we duly give, we keep that respect, then we are in one way or the other promoting peace. So I must say welcome again to this topic and to this day that we are celebrating, the International Day for Living Together in Peace. I believe we can live together in peace. I believe we can ensure that, and I believe it can be done. So thank you for having you on board to do justice to this topic. Thank you very much for everyone joining us. Thank you, and God bless you. Over to you, Honorable Moderator, Princess Sevi. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That is our president, our CEO, the founder of this HOPE organization. That is our man hailing from Nigeria. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Welcome to everybody. Now that we have been unleashed, now that we have been released, now that we have been told that we can be at home and do what we are here for, I just would like maybe to just give one quote as I am preparing Honorable Ambassador Andrew Williams Jr. from USA, preparing himself for his 10 minutes presentation. So one quote that I have, it says, "Peace in the home is the peace for the community." This is by Leila Gifty Agita. Peace in the home is the peace in the community. I just would like to leave it there as a food for thought as we continue in this journey. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, let us allow on the stage Ambassador Prince Andrew Williams Jr. from USA. Thank you.
Well, greetings everyone, and thank you. I'm going to share my screen and welcome everyone here to today's International Day of Living Together in Peace, brought to you by the World Human Organization for Peace and Equity. Pastor James made a very important point. It is only when we respect the rights of ourselves and others that we can begin to achieve peace. Royal greetings to all. I wear many honorary titles, including His Royal Highness, Prince Andrew Williams Jr., Ambassador Williams, and Dr. Williams. I'm honored to join you today as the International Chairperson of the World Humanitarian Organization for Peace and Equity, President of the Five Points Youth Foundation, and Global Advisor to the DEV7 Sustainable Development Initiative. All of these are your co-sponsors of this event that you'll find at the bottom of the flyer. Let me express my special thanks to Ambassador James, Chaplain Josephine, my beloved daughter, Princess Sepi, distinguished speakers, those joining us live, and those we reach through this live streaming to the Ayakba Network, Facebook group, Ayakba TV channel 305 on UCIT.tv, and worldwide broadcast channels based here in Los Angeles, California, in the United States of America. Before I proceed, however, I'm going to also stop my sharing my screen about this event and take us back to 2020. When we did, in fact, come together through HOPE to pull together multiple ambassadors from around the world to address peace. I certainly am humbled and my heart is broken this morning to report that to you that here in the United States, again, we're suffering from a mass killing that is seems to be motivated by hate. So what we want to do, just take you back to 2020. This is not our first event. We are in fact doing this, not just today and not just tomorrow, but forever. We've made our commitment to do so. And we're inviting all of you to participate with us in this upcoming 2022 International Day of Peace. Last year, Princess Sepi, James, Meenakshi, Saudi, all of these are our goodwill ambassadors. So last year's theme was peace to achieve the sustainable development goals. that won't change. But we do want to invite each of you and all of you to register in advance for our upcoming event. I'll put that in the chat. From a perspective of my responsibility as a human being, human right number 29 is that we take responsibility. And I'm asking each of you to take responsibility in your own lives, in your own communities, in your own families, and in your own region or language or culture, to begin with building peace from within that can expand worldwide. On a similar note, it is in fact here in the United States, Representative Barbara Lee, who in 2001 was the only congressperson that voted against the United States involvement in the Iraq War, that has now transitioned into an endless war. It is she who here in the United States is also the congressperson that was our representative to the United Nations during last year's General Assembly. She has been holding that position in the two previous assemblies. We hope she'll be holding it coming up. We want to ask all of you around the world that have representatives, family members, or others in what's called the diaspora from your country that are here in the United States to support our efforts, to support Barbara Lee, and creating what's called the United States Institute of Peace. We've never had an Institute of Peace. I should say a Department of Peace. As I said, I'm here in Los Angeles. In addition to the other organizations I represent the Ed Food Foundation based in Oakland, California. They work closely with Congresswoman Lee over the years. So we're gonna ask all of you to contact the Pastor James so that we can work through EdFlu to bring peace to our streets. In that regard, I am also on the National Advisory Board for the Universal Hip Hop Museum. It was over 5 years ago when the United States Ambassador from the African Union, or I should say the ambassador to the diaspora, that reached out to me personally because she understood that our youth are the future and it will be up to our youth to drive the culture to change our future. In that regard, we have celebrated here in Los Angeles, peace in the streets. As a result of the COVID-19 pandemic and other factors, we've had an uptick in crime, but it's up to us to show our children how we are working together for peace. They won't listen to what we say. They only watch what we do. So I'm going to ask all of you to join us in preparing for the upcoming September 21st, 2022, International Day of Peace through WOPE. I'll put that information into the chat and I turn it back over to our moderator. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That is our ambassador across the Atlantic in the USA, Ambassador Prince Andrew Williams Jr. Wonderful words. He is there requesting all of us to join hands in really rallying for peace, whichever community, whichever family, wherever you are. Thank you so much. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, we will carry on. I'm not sure if our Dr. Yewande is here. If she is not yet, I don't see her among the participants. We will go right along. We have USA, we have United Kingdom, we have Italy, we have India. So right now we will go to Professor Arch Umberto Puato. I think I saw Prof from Italy. Yes, Prof, the stage is yours. You have 10 minutes. You can unmute yourself. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear you.
How do you do?
Thank you. We are doing
very well.
Best wishes
from Rome. Best wishes from Rome. Thank you to everybody. I am with Ambassador together here in near me. Ambassador advocated Marcella Crimi Giorgiani, who speaks after me when you desire. Dear greetings to all present speakers and listeners from Rome and the Vatican City. First of all, I thank our President Ambassador Dr. James Mercy Otamumbi. Also, on behalf of Ambassador Advocate Marcella Crimi Giorgiani, we will continue my introduction speech for having included us in this conference as reference and coordinators of a World Humanitarian Organization.
You're muted, sir. Please unmute yourself. We cannot hear you. Try again. We cannot hear you.
You are still muted.
Humberto may have to come out. He may have to go out and come back in. We cannot hear him.
We cannot hear you.
I'll remove him, so he'll have to come back in. You can go to the next speaker if you choose or wait.
Professor Umberto? Professor? Professor, we cannot hear you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, while Professor is still logging in, let us see if we have the next speaker. Do we have Dr. Pratibha from India? Dr. Pratibha Mishra from India. Dr. Pratibha Mishra from India. It doesn't look like it. So we will go to the next speaker. Irwan Rusli. I think I saw Irwan. Dr. Irwan Rusli.
Hello.
Yes, we can.
I hope everyone hear you, can sir. Hear me.
We can hear you. Perhaps just if you can, so that your head doesn't, we can see your head. Just a little bit up your phone or your gadget.
Okay, would that be okay?
Yes.
I would just,
yes. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
My name is Irwan Rusli. I'm actually from Indonesia. So you need to add one more country, Indonesia. My domicile is in US. So I've been, my program is in US. I'm the president of the Rusli Institute of Technology and Development. Our main area is trying to do, to apply technology in various area related to the development. So we are dealing mainly for rural development area, that including the poverty alleviation and other area. The one I would like to mention in this brief kind of presentation that I have here is dealing with the living in peace. I think basically we have to deal with two important aspects. One is the economy and the other is the social aspect. However, these two aspects are tied together. And the thing that we need to do actually is more on the transparency aspect of it. Because I think we have to be honest that in many situations, whether developing country as well as developed country, one of the main problems is corruption. How do we deal with corruption? How do we prevent corruption? Corruption is come in many different ways, different forms, whether it is money corruption, whether it is environmental corruption, whether it is other aspect of corruption. I'm talking about pollution. I'm talking about education, healthcare. A lot of these things are affected. So when we're talking about social and economy, they're all tied together, and they're all under the umbrella of transparency. That's what we need right now in terms of this transparency. How do we be transparent to each other, whether it is within a country or whether among countries? So this is how things that we can develop. Maybe we can see this is a very long way and rough way going through toward transparency, total transparency. But I think this is the only way we can be able to be peacefully living together with the economic as well as social aspect, where the well-being of society, communities, and so on can be guaranteed. So I think my point is that how do we define this transparency? The way I see transparency is something that a system in which with high degree of certainty that something can be achieved, that some desirable thing can be achieved, or some undesirable thing cannot be achieved or prevented. So in this case, for example, if we are dealing with the situation with funding, money situation, so the transparency is dealing with the how do we spend money. If this is this money is designed for people, for the poor people, then make sure that all this money are going to the right target, to the poor, not going anywhere else. So how do we make certain about this? We have to guide this money. We have to monitor this money. We have to see how they are being spent, what kind of things being purchased, what kind of things being being made, what quality that being being produced. So all these things have to be connected. The same thing with the concept of pollution. So the corruption could be also in the form of pollution. If some factory dispose of their waste into the river or the ocean, it will affecting this river that might not be helpful, or it's contaminated and it's very dangerous for people, for example, swimming in the river. So we need to be transparent with respect to this factory. How much, what kind of chemical they are being produced, how much they are being produced, make sure that chemical being disposed is being neutralized or being corrected, so that's no longer a threat to the community. So this is also very important, for example, to our climate change. We're talking about CO2 evolution, pollution. We have to make sure that we have to be open. How much CO2 is being exposed to the atmosphere? Each individual factory has to be open about how much CO2 being disposed to the air. Each country has to be honest about recording how much CO2 that they being disposed. So with all these things, we will be able to control, we will be able to monitor so that improvement or some kind of step can be done in order to solve the problem. So it's connected. And the consequence of all these things are poverty. Consequence of this is healthcare. Consequence of this is a lack of education. So all these things are connected to each other. And so the main problem right now is how can we be transparent to each other? I think that's practically all my presentation. And let us do some discussion about this. Let's talk about how do we eliminate corruption or prevent corruption, so that we can trace all the money, all the things that affecting our life, make it transparent so that all the stakeholders will know about it. They can understand what's going on, so they can act accordingly. So thank you for this opportunity, and let us work together starting now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Dr. Rusley, Irwan Rusley. Thank you so much. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. So well put. And we all have heard, and all of us, I would like to just let us put in the chat what is our contribution to really try and make peace in our communities, in our families, in our own space. And as we are saying, let it not just be about us, it has already been displayed that we've been running with this right from 2020. And I know that it wasn't the first one, it's just that perhaps because of the pandemic, then we started gathering in this manner, virtual conferences. So ladies and gentlemen, I would like to say thank you so much. I think I am done with the section where I was moderating. I would like to now say thank you very much for all the speakers that have already presented, powerful speakers, powerful presentations that have been made. I will now step down and leave the stage to my co-host, who is Chaplain Josephine Ikunehenbu from Nigeria. Chaplain, I can see you are back. I would like you to take over the stage. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Nyabong. Chaplain Josephine, can you hear me? Chaplain Josephine? Chaplain Josephine?
All right, you can continue to shift back.
While Chaplain is coming through, perhaps let me just leave you with the nuggets. I have some quote here while Chaplain is preparing herself. The other quote we have already read. And then I just would like to read from the Holy Bible. It says in the book of Proverbs 21, verse 9, it is better to live in a corner of the roof than in a house shared with a contentious woman. You can also say with a contentious human being, so that we don't point fingers and say it's only women that can be contentious. Even men, we all have a responsibility to create peace in our families. Once we are able to be peaceful in our families, it will cascade into our communities. The other one, what I have noticed in my own space is that, or even experience, is trauma can cause people or can cause us to live in fear. So when we live in fear, we respond through fear. Everything that we do, we become very reactive because of fear. So when we are motivated by fear, peace really runs out. And all what we are seeing is anger, is unjust, is hatred. And even the words that come out sometimes, you know, we can't even believe that did I really say such words? It's because of the fear that has engulfed us. So also the word of God says, out of the heart speaketh the mouth. Let us try and guard our peace with all that we can. Try and live peacefully with all those that are around us. Yes, it is not easy, but it is doable. It is possible. And if it is not about, if it is not me, who there? Let it start with me. Let it start with you. Chaplain, are you ready? Chaplain Josephine, are you ready? Okay, we will carry on then. To our next speakers. We have Ambassador Lloyd Hafferty from Canada. Ambassador, you have 10 minutes, my dear sir.
Oh, thank you very much, Princess, for that. I just wanted to introduce myself. I am Lloyd Hafferty, the Chief Ecosystem Director, Program Development Director, Sustainable Society Consultant. I'm working with Energon University in Manhattan, in New York. I am in the Toronto, in Greater Toronto area of Canada, Ontario. So I'm with this university, Energon University, a 501c nonprofit. We are a member of the UN Global Compact, also what's called a UN Academic Impact Member and Partner. And it is a virtual university, so we don't have a physical campus. But the university was created to empower global populations to reestablish a sustainable balance with the local environments. And we do this really by designing and implementing projects to support strong, diversified local economies, integrating various core sustainable technologies, different infrastructure solutions into communities. So areas of renewable energy, high density food growth, and other solutions for managing local waste, protecting local water resources. So it is a collaboration in itself, over 375 companies that we represent in their technologies, but the way we approach communities is to bring the communities together to support especially the education and training around things like the construction, deployment, maintenance of all the various solutions for achieving closed loop systems, closed loop economies that really support self-sufficient, sustainable communities. So what I have been doing recently in partnership, we have a partnership that was created a few years ago called We Energize Global Cooperation Turtle Island as an international civil society organization, bringing together three organizations, We the World, Energize University, and Global Cooperation Day. And so that we seek to do something called Life Value Peace Education alongside the technical and other types of training in local communities for achieving these sustainable development goals at the local level. But we do this training in the context of what we call life learning gardens, which we are now bringing together to create a global unity network where we are working with local people to establish local teams to support humanitarian entrepreneurs. So these local teams we call the INAP collaboratives, which bring together seven sectors of the community to establish local community unity gardens, as we call them. These are education and training centers, especially for youth, but for all community members, really all families, to understand these solutions. And so I was also designated as a Goodwill Ambassador by Andrew Williams Jr. For the 5 Points Youth Foundation originally. So I do have a portfolio that covers Canada, La Francophonie, the Commonwealth of Nations, and Turtle Island, which is here in North America. So this ad hoc international advisory board of Goodwill Ambassadors seeking to empower our communities to engage with the Royal Indigenous Tribal Leadership and help to bring local communities to establish these INAP collaboratives, which means Interfaith Neighborhood Academic and Business Collaboratives. So those members of the collaboratives come to support the local humanitarian entrepreneurs who are, as we say, globalizing the global goals. Of course, now we are in the stage of the Sustainable Development Goals, which has a mandate of leaving no one behind. So as we move forward, we are building this global unity network. And so we are establishing a business, UnityNet International, which is working with an organization in Africa, UnityNet Africa and the Diaspora, to bring together local communities to implement this process of localization of the global goals. And then we want to replicate that UnityNet Africa Diaspora model around the rest of the world, of course, back here in North America, Turtle Island, as well as in Asia, and Eurasia, I should say, in Europe as well, eventually. So we came together actually as a coalition of small businesses. And so this Global Unity Network, which we are building, we are having this process of engagement where we begin with planting the trees of peace and reconciliation in our local communities to bring together the partners at the local level to support as we call our female and feminist humanitarian entrepreneurs. And so I just actually can share my screen as well, just to show you a couple of events that we are having coming up. Just give me a second to expand some more windows. So we have our first event coming up is, actually this is not quite the one that is. So we have, yes, two events that I wanted to show here. One we call the Tea Diplomacy Initiative. That's actually coming up on May 21st. So this coming Saturday, where we are have a virtual event, and I would like everybody to be able to attend this event as well, because it is a virtual conversation to help bring people in these local communities together with some of the decision makers who are implementing or making decisions, I think, at the higher level in terms of especially these large scale programs that are being developed, whether by governments or corporations or others. So we want them to understand the actual needs of people in these local communities. So this is coming up again as Saturday, May 21st, starting at 8, where we are bringing all of our members of this Global Unity Network together. So we now do have over 500 members over all of our social networks. We do build our network on social media, Facebook and LinkedIn and WhatsApp for the most part. And we have weekly conversations called the Indigenous Unity Network IGU Summit events every Thursday as well. We have another event coming up on June 5th, what we call the Abraham Project Tree of Peace and Reconciliation Tree Planting Event. And so you'll see in the picture on the screen is the Tree of Peace and Reconciliation Tree Planting, as we call it, Showcase Project for Global Cooperation, where we'd like all of our local communities who are implementing some of the solutions, the what we call open source regenerative climate smart infrastructure solutions set up as these Unity Garden learning centers in each local community, partnering with the local existing local, whether it's universities or colleges or schools, could be high schools or even down to grade schools, where they come together to teach people, especially young people, as we focus on youth and the transformation of our economy from this current stage of the Sustainable Development Goals, the SDGs, started in 2015 and go to 2030. So we're looking out 8 years from now to the post-2030 world of what is the next stage of the global goals. We would like to start demonstrating many of the solutions for achieving what we call a collaborative regenerative economy that leaves no one behind. And so these are the purpose of having these events and setting up our network so that we can begin to demonstrate all of these real world solutions to achieving what we'll call the regenerative economy. So I'll leave it at that. I am, as I said, the founder or co-founder of the Global Unity Network. Our partner is actually in Sierra Leone by the name of, rearranging my desktop here. So Carlos Richard Sanko, who's working with me. We have a team here in Toronto. So we want all of our members to be empowered. We call ourselves a global empowerment network of female and feminist humanitarian entrepreneurs in local communities who are beginning to demonstrate what we call climate smart solutions for regenerative economy. So this is the work that I've been doing for the last year or so, with the support of Andrew Networks and the Ad Hoc International Advisory Board of Goodwill Ambassadors. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You surprised me today. Thank you. Very well said, and great job that you have been doing, all the team of the UnityNet, you know, planting of the trees through agriculture, bringing people together, everyone. I know the great work we have, some of the members from my own country in South Africa, which are doing also the great work that all of you are doing. Thank you so much, Lloyd. Thank you for that presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, let us go on with our day, the International Day of Living Peacefully Together, of living together in peace. Do not forget, those that have just joined us, we highly appreciate you. Dr. Lloyd, we can now take down your presentation. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Let us know if you've just joined us as to where are you joining from. Just say hi. I am Tepi from South Africa. I'm Arbri Merkaj, and this is the country I'm from. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. And let us know in your corner, how are you promoting peace? How are you preserving peace? How are you contributing to making peace practically? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, let us hear from Philippines, Virginia Winnie Piyas. You have 10 minutes, madam. Virginia? I think there was a hand up. I saw the hand. Anyway, Virginia, the stage is yours. Okay.
Thank you very much, Francis. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Well, as I'm the CEO, founder of King Global Minds in Development, we're pioneering with this development and giving education that is very, very important in reaching out these people in the mountains and barangays. So our organization is, we do also development in reaching them out, and by this, what we're doing, and also we're doing peace, or giving peace and love for them. With the LGUs, they have requested for the building, especially this pandemic. What we're doing now, because of this, there really lack of school buildings, so. As Ashley, the other ambassador, had told us, that is a very important in giving service for what we are doing now. Well, when we have peace and love, humility, respect to everyone, traditions, easy to give love and happy to serve everyone. By this, we are contributing peace, national and international, peace around the globe. I encourage everyone then that in reaching and doing our job, we should be strong and always do our missions in our community and country, outside and in, as a peace lover. By this, we are contributing as everybody is doing now. So I hope even in the future, like tree planting as Lloyd, Sir Lloyd, as Erwin is telling about the monitoring of what the development we're giving for these people, we should do this a very good symposium or this Zoom meeting that I attend for this HOPE organization is a big opportunity and a big help for me as a leader also of this organization. Thank you very much, Frances. And this is Virginia from Philippines.
Virginia, thank you so much. We welcome you, and we hope to see you once again in the upcoming event that we are going to be holding as HOPE. And we want to also appreciate you for the great work that you are doing. you know, making that a difference. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. May you continue and may you be strengthened and may you not tire. Thank you. Thank you so much, Virginia. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome on stage Italy, Marcella Crimi Giorgiani. Marcella Crimi Giorgiani, Italy. Marcella Crimi Giorgiani, the stage is yours, ma'am. Yes, thank you.
¿Me escuchan? Querida, ¿me escuchan?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, the stage is yours, ma'am.
Hello.
Thank you.
Thank you. Grazie per questa esposizione. Comunque l'ambasciatore Jaime Mercy mi ha detto che posso parlare in la lingua spagnola, quindi lo farò in quella lingua. Agradezco questa opportunità e, bueno, la verdad che è molto importante el tema el cual nos convoca a través de diversos universos, a través de diversos continentes y de diversas ciudades. Cuando pensaba en escribir mi relación acerca de la paz, se acercó mi hija de 10 años y me preguntó, mamá, ¿por qué cada vez escriben más sobre la paz? Y eso hizo un clic en mi persona. Y me hizo pensar realmente por qué tantas veces hablamos de la paz. Y es realmente porque lo necesitamos. Y la paz únicamente la podemos lograr trabajando desde dentro, desde nuestra propia conciencia, desde nuestro propio corazón. Sabemos de que no es algo imposible, tampoco es una utopía. Pero únicamente la conseguiremos si lo logramos hacer desde nuestro propio interior, trasladándolo hacia todos los demás y uniendo las fuerzas. Esto no es lo que yo había preparado. Pensaba hablar en algo más extenso. Creo que el internet nos ha jugado una mala pasada y por eso, bueno, yo los llamo a todos a tomar conciencia de lo que significa la paz, lo que podemos trabajar con ella, empezando desde el campo, empezando desde nuestro propio interior, empezando desde nuestra casa, con nuestros hijos, con nuestros vecinos, con nuestra pareja. Y si de algo estoy totalmente segura, es que no habrá paz mientras exista una sola persona en el mundo sin casa, sin techo, sin alimentos, sin vestimentas, sin los recursos para construir y satisfacer las necesidades básicas. Por eso yo los insto y me insto a mí misma a seguir luchando por una palabrita tan chica, que es la primera respuesta que yo tuve cuando le pregunté al embajador Humberto Poato qué era para él la paz. Y él me contestó sonriendo y tomando una pausa. Es una palabra muy pequeñita, pero significa tanto. Yo los invito a seguir trabajando por esto desde nuestro propio interior y sobre todo a los jóvenes, que son los futuros protagonistas de la sociedad que nosotros les estamos dejando, y a nuestros niños, a trabajar por la paz. Otro mundo es posible. Muchas gracias por todo. Un saludo a todos desde Roma, Italia. Gracias.
Thank you so much, Marcela. Thank you so much. The only thing I know to say is gracias. The only thing I understood is gracias. I'm not too sure if do we have anybody who can interpret, perhaps.
Umberto,
is Professor near you?
Professor Mbatu.
Would
you like to
I have had a little problem with audio, I believe now we can see and hear. Is right?
Yes, see, yes.
Is right, so?
Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead, please.
Okay.
You have two microphones on. Please turn one off.
Can you hear now?
Yes. No.
We can hear from Marcela and not you, Prof. Mbatu. Let her unmute herself. And you speak. We can't hear you. Let Marcela unmute herself so we can hear you. Let Marcela unmute herself so we can hear you from her. Professor Mbatu, we can't hear you. Marcela, unmute yourself. All right, unmute her.
Everything's right now.
Yes, it's still okay that way.
Okay.
Yes, but
yes, we can hear you now. Please go ahead.
Can you hear well now?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, just we can hear you.
Just a moment. Okay. It is right now?
Yes.
Perfect. Perfect.
Okay. A dear greetings to all present speakers and listeners from Rome and the Vatican City. First of all, I thank our President Ambassador, Dr. James Mercy Obatun Mibi. Also, on behalf of Ambassador Lower Marcela Crimin Giorgiani, who has spoken now in my introduction speech, for having included us in this a very, very interesting conference, and as reference and coordinators of WHOPE, World Humanitarian Organization for Peace and Equity, of course, activities in Europe. I want to remember our dearest Martin Luther King, who said, if humanity is to progress, Gandhi's teachings are essential. He lived for, acted, and who is inspired by the vision of a humanity capable of evolving towards a world of peace and harmony. A very beautiful remember. I believe personally, like Umberto, that we can all share this fall as an example proposal for living together in peace according to the purpose of evolution of consciousness that disregards ethnic origins, religions, economy, wealth, and which can unite us through culture, environmental protection, and dialogue. The importance of dialogue between us, human beings. We were all born somewhere on Earth and the right to live, there is peace comes from the natural law that distinguished human beings, but also the animal and plant world. It is therefore our task to protect these rights, in particular human rights, according to the rights conquered in the evolution of the history and sanctioned in particular by the United Nations Charter of San Francisco of 1945. And in the case of Europe, by the Lisbon Treaty of 2007, which notoriously stimulated the adhering countries to unite in mutual aid and concrete action of solidarity in case of need, such as, for example, states of calamity, economic imbalances, or unfortunately in the current cases of war conflict we know. Meanwhile, peace and harmony derive from our personal inner balance, then familiar or relationship with others, already not easy to obtain, and therefore from the socio-economic balances that can lead to a state of equity, like our organization VOPE, World Humanitarian Organization for Peace and Equity, OPS, and for which it and we all work. We can summarize in 10 points a real concrete program for a way of peace. I go hurry, then if it is necessary, we will publish on Facebook on the other, these 10 points I have write down. I don't want take too much time to you and your gentle hearing.
If it's only 10 points, please take the time to read them. You can also put them in the chat.
Yes, I read only by the first, seek unconditional love. Two, moderate our absolute beliefs by always being ready to question and reflect. Three, we must be tolerant. Four, we must be in peaceful, like Gandhi said. There are many causes for which I am willing to die, but no cause for which I am willing to kill. Five, think. We must think before action. Six, forgiveness and not revenge. 7 point, find inner peace. 8 point, live with happiness. 9 point, be part of the change we want to see in the world. Like, for example, participate in a peace one day of the International Day of Peace by United Nations on 21st of September annually. And so going on. Last point, expand our understanding of peace together. Collaborate like we succeed in doing in this conference and other one. We work around all the world, like, for example, VOA, World Organization of Ambassadors, founded by our great friend Pastor Martin Mauro in Argentina, Buenos Aires, originally denominated Organization Mundial de Ambassador, and then World Human Commission by Mr. Ambassador Zelli, we know in Nigeria, and then World Academy of Human Sciences by Professor Salezio Pereira in Miami and in Brazil. And of course, going on in Europe, Africa, South America, etc., etc. And we can resume all United Nations believing organization in the world. Thank you. Thanks again, everyone, for your kind listening.
Grazie.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Professor. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We have heard you quoting Mahatma Gandhi, the great Mahatma Gandhi. Thank you so much. I think we don't, do we have Barista Enesara? If Barista is not here, what we are going to do to appreciate everybody who is here, I'm going to run through, you have 1 minute to just greet, say the country where you are, greet, say the country where you are. Abri Merkaj, I'm gonna start with you.
And please unmute yourself and show your video if possible.
Yes, show your video, greet, do not do any speech. Greet and say this is the country where you are. Arbij Merkaj, if Arbij is not here, Emmanuel Lompo. Emmanuel Lompo, all those that have not spoken, I'm going to be calling you. Arbij Merkaj, just show your video, the country where you are, hi, and the country.
And perhaps everyone that can hear us, share your video. Then we'll know that you're ready to introduce yourself. Thank you.
Emmanuel? Andre? Emmanuel? Andre? Andre? Andre van der Merwe.
Good evening. My name is Andre van der Merwe, and I'm in full support of what we are trying to do. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Your country.
That's North Africa, my neighbor. Thank you. The following one.
My name is Emmanuel from Burkina Faso.
Thank you, Burkina Faso. Juliet. Juliet. If Juliet cannot hear, Lisa Anise Stadfin.
Yes, I'm here in San Francisco, USA. I work for the International
Patrick, thank you so much, Lisa. Patrick, speak.
Hello there. Good evening, everyone. This is Patrick Nkoma from Malawi. Thank you so much.
We didn't see you. Mark, thank you so much, Patrick. Patrick, you can now mute yourself. After you have spoken, please mute yourself. Let's go. Mark P.
Hi, this is
Mark is not
Prasangi here. I'm from Toronto, Canada. And this is a great set of conversation happening over here. Love being here. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. It looks like we're anybody who has not spoken, please show your video and greet. Arbi Merkaj Mohammed.
Hello, I'm Mohammed from West Africa, Guinea Conakry. Thank you very much. I'm pleased to
be here. Thank you. We are pleased to see you. Merkaj, anybody who has not spoken, show your video and greet.
Hello.
Yes.
I'm Rudy Atu. I'm from Sierra Leone, West Africa, President of the United States of America.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Welcome. Maxime, can you hear us? Maxime, can you hear us? Otherwise, we are closing. Ladies and gentlemen, we are at the end of our session. What a wonderful day we have had. I think let us all show the video so that we can all now take that picture, the famous picture, and smile. And smile, make sure that you can show very nicely. Show the picture and mute yourself. Ambassador Andrew, do you want to do the click?
Let everyone do the click. And then share with Pastor James.
All right. And Lloyd, anybody who can do the click so that we have this also in our records.
Okay, that's a wonderful one.
You did?
Peace, everyone.
Oh,
yes. Let peace prevail. Let peace prevail. Let there be peace. Let there be peace. Oh,
thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Make sure to sign up for the Eventbrite page. We're planting many trees of peace. Just
love
2 weeks.
Everyone, make sure we have your contact information in the chat. We'll give you a few seconds if you want to save the chat or contact Pastor James afterwards, and we'll send an email out to everyone that whose contact we have.
Yes, indeed. Thank you, everybody, for making time. Thank you for being such a good, well-mannered participants. Thank you from all countries where you are. Please put your contact details and the organization in the chat. And if you'd like to also keep in touch, you can also save in the chat. Save.
Oh, wait. Queen Nina. We have Queen Nina. Are you ready to make a presentation, Queen Nina?
My goodness, we were just saying our goodbyes. So you are the one who's going to do the amen. Queen Nina, you can greet.
You didn't miss it. Unmute yourself and participate. Show your video. If possible.
Can you guys hear me?
Now we hear you. Yeah. But can we see you?
Not right now.
Okay, give us what you got.
About international peace, I just came on, so what?
Well, Queen Nina, you're always ready. This is about the International Day for Peace. So you are the one that's going to tell us about living together in peace. Thank you. Go right ahead.
Thank you so much, Prince Andrew.
You have 10 minutes if you choose.
Absolutely. I just want to emphasize the importance of coming together as one human being, as one. And that's how, that's how we need to start thinking collectively. All the major scientists have proven that all of our DNA is basically the same. The only thing that differentiates one human being from another is 0.1%. So we are 99% identical, man, woman of any nationality, race, and so forth. And it is simply 1% that differentiates us. So when we start keep operating, thinking separate, and thinking individualized, and my race is the most efficient, and you know this race is that. When we start separating ourselves, this is what's causing a lot of disunity and a lot of racism and prejudice and so forth. When we can see through a vision of oneness, that every human being, every plant, everything in this earth is all interconnected and we are one, then that's when we move into a state of international peace and unity. So that's something to consider, you know, okay, we are more alike than we are different. So where can we find our similarities in culture, in thought? You know, one thing I notice about people is that all of us smile, all of us want love, all of us get angry, all of us enjoy music, all of us need to eat. Like, we have these basic things in common as human beings that every single person does, no matter where you come from, your age, whatever. You know, we all do the same thing: eat, smile, love, get angry, and so forth. So that goes to show how we're so much alike, how we are 99% alike. We have two arms, two legs, two eyes, like all of our body parts are the same. So can we move to that point where we start seeing each other as one instead of as separate? And that's what I want to leave with us, really, you know, pondering that whether you're African, whether you're from the diaspora, whether you're European, Asian, from India, that we're alike. We're 99% alike. We're 99% identical. Can we get to that point where we start seeing each other like that? Now, what I'm doing as a Black woman of African descent, as an activist, as a humanitarian, is I am being proactive right now. I've been doing this for quite some time to heal the trauma and the damage between people of African descent, people in the diaspora who have been enslaved, and people in Africa who have been colonized. My life's mission and my work is to help us heal. But the reason why I am putting forth that effort to help people of African descent heal is once we become whole, then we can truly embrace our brothers and sisters from other cultures and races and nationalities. Let me tell you, before I was educated and empowered of who I am as a Black woman of African descent, before I found out the truth about Africa, I didn't have self-love. I didn't have love and pride in myself as a Black woman. Therefore, I really didn't care too much or have love and pride about other races because I didn't even love myself. But once I became enlightened and truly began to love myself, then I was able to love others. Then I was able to love my white brothers and sisters and my Asian brothers and sisters and my Native American brothers and sisters because I found self-love within myself. So that is the key to developing our own self-love. So then, therefore, we can love others the same as we love ourselves.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Back to you, moderator.
Great. Thank you. Powerful words, powerful words. So you definitely took, you maximized on your few minutes of just arriving. Thank you so much. We had already said thank you. We had already done our picture. And ladies and gentlemen, it is adios from me. And thank you for making time. We'll see you again next time. Thank you.
However, those of you that can stay, I will be sharing a 30-minute video on the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It is necessary for us to first understand that peace is only a function of our humanity. So those of you that must leave, goodbye. For those that you can stay with us, I'm going to share this video. Thank you so very much for your participation.
Great. Gracias. Muito obrigada. Siyabonga, siyabonga. Asante sana.
Can you tell which of these children was not born free? Can you tell which of these children was not born equal? Can you tell which of these children does not deserve to be treated with dignity? We can't either. Human right number one. We are all born free and equal. What are human rights? Find out at youthforhumanrights.org. Greeted you at birth. It was there for your first step. Your first mistake. Your first kiss. It's with you when you win. When you lose. When you pick yourself up again. In every moment, you can feel it. Life. Human right number three, the right to life. What are human rights? Find out at youthforhumanrights.org.
Kids, here we are at the slavery exhibit. Now, as you can see, the slaves were kidnapped from their homes, chained together for weeks. They would cram them onto these ships in very appalling conditions.
Thousands of women and children are being smuggled across the border.
Sexual trafficking of children.
As you can see right here, they were treated like animals. They worked all day long for no pay.
In sweatshops raided by police. Children forced into slave labor.
Some of the slave masters were very cruel. They whipped them and they beat them, as you can see in some of these pictures.
Torture and assault can be brutal, even fatal.
So, before moving on, are there any questions?
Does this still happen today?
When I was walking home from school, they asked me for my money. I said no.
And all my friends ran home because they were scared he might punch them too.
I was screaming, but he just wouldn't stop.
He always said he would hit me. I just didn't think he actually would.
I don't know what I did, but they just kept on kicking me.
They tied me up and dragged me outside. They stripped me of my dignity.
She said she was going to teach me a lesson.
He said I wasn't listening. I didn't think he'd get so mad.
Thank you.
You need it out!
Hold it by James. Right. Welcome to my country, my friends.
I have right.
Really? Where do you think you are?
I have right.
I have right!
Only rights you have
here!
Not rights. I keep you.
Ready! One! Two!
Different words describe different people. But in the eyes of the law, there's one that fits us all. Human right number 7. We're all equal before the law. What are human rights? Find out at youthforhumanrights.org.
This is a story about human rights. For those that don't know, you need to. Yo, a starving artist, but his lyrics sold worldwide. His friend and manager was a snake in disguise, and he was bitten. His song sold without his permission. Saw his record on the shelf, the snake had stolen his vision. But knowing his rights, he could protect himself. Fair treatment by fair courts, he got the law to help. The other dude just sunk weak, looked like a punk. Could hardly open his mouth to speak, popping that junk. You better get up, stand up, if you've been done wrong. You better stand up for your rights like that Marley song. Get yourself represented, lawfully defended. Know your human rights, don't ever surrender. No, don't ever surrender. Yeah.
Anybody out there? This isn't right. Why don't you just tell me what I did, please? Can somebody just tell me? Gosh, just talk to somebody. Let me go.
People versus Martin White. Mr. White has been charged with...
Guilty! Next case!
But, Ronnie, you haven't heard the charges yet!
Guilty! Next!
Can you tell which of these children was not born equal? Can you tell which of these children does not deserve to be treated with dignity?
Next case.
People versus Martin White. Mr. White has been charged with...
Guilty! Next case!
But, Ronnie, you haven't heard the charges yet!
Guilty! Next case! Guilty! Guilty! Guilty!
I'm Chinese.
I am Russian.
I am East African.
I'm Canadian.
I am Filipina.
I am Irish.
I am Bulgarian.
Korean.
I am American.
I am Brazilian.
Italian.
Mexican.
I'm British.
Swedish.
French.
I'm Israeli.
Mongolian.
I'm South African.
Japanese.
We are mankind.
Thank you.
She came up and kissed me one day.
It was an impulse. I just grabbed him and I kissed him on the lips and I ran away.
Because I was like 20 years old. It's not like something you talk about marriage all the time.
But I asked for her number. She wouldn't give me her number.
No, I think he liked me first for sure because...
She's hot.
We met in a grocery store.
We were in a class together.
Came up to me one day, says, I got this perfect girl for you.
He was a good dancer, but not too good.
Like he was my soulmate.
She's my queen. Of course, I'm the king.
I said, I have to ask you something. She said, what? And I kneeled down. And
she was laughing and trembling.
She gets so embarrassed.
What did I say? I said, will you marry me or will you be my wife?
Will you be my wife?
He proposed to me on my birthday.
And she said, yes. Are you sure?
Sorry.
I believe in nature.
I believe in the spirit.
I believe in trust.
Beauty.
I believe in my mom.
Strawberry ice cream.
Fortune cookies.
Chocolate.
I believe in
the tooth fairy.
Being honest with yourself.
I believe in Santa Claus.
Aliens, of course.
I believe what I want to believe.
I believe in myself.
I believe in myself.
I believe in peace.
Not paying attention.
I need the people
on the paper.
I'm
sitting
down.
I'm sitting down.
Hey, wait up. There's a mistake. I am more than this.
Seems okay to me, kid. Maybe you should check your math.
Hey there.
Hey, boss.
Maybe you should check yours.
According to estimates, over 1 billion people live in appalling levels of poverty. Denied even basic standards of food, water. Nearly half of the world's population earns less than.
Now, Krista, make sure you stay with her the whole time. She's new to the country. This is her first
Mom,
day. This
Mom,
is a brand
Mom,
new country.
Mom,
it's a whole different culture.
It's gonna be okay.
Now, make sure you stay with her the whole time. I'll be here right after school to pick you up.
Okay, Mom.
Okay, have fun. Bye-bye.
Bye. Ignore my mom. She's so annoying. She's totally freaking out about this whole thing. She freaks out about everything. She always does that. Ugh. Ignore my mom. So, ready for your first day in the Wicked Castle of Doom? So boring. I don't know how they could put us through this, like, every single day.
How many schools do you have in your village? None.
Dude.
Man. This is pirated.
So?
So, I wanted the real thing.
What's the difference, man?
The difference? So when I start making movies, people ripping me off.
I wouldn't rip you off, man.
Prove it.
The world I see is fair and free, where people can travel wherever they please, and children can eat and have shoes on their feet, and not be afraid when they walk on the street. It's not like there has to be rainbows and bunnies. The streets full of people are dancing like dummies, but freedom to live, to learn, and to play, to just be yourself, and think your own way. The road I see may sound crazy to you, but hopefully, someday, you'll see it too.
morning. I'm here to read you your rights.
My what?
We're all free and equal. Don't discriminate. You have the right to life.
You have the right to life and to live in freedom and safety.
You have a right to education. You have a right to your own things.
You have the right to social security. You have the right to play.
You have the right to democracy. You have the right to asylum.
You have the right to take responsibility.
And no one
and nobody can take these rights and freedoms away from you.
Why are you doing this?
You have a right to know.
These are your human rights. There are 30 of them. They belong to you. You don't have to buy them, or apply for them, or ask permission to have them. They're just yours. No matter who you are, where you're from, how old you are, or anything else, it's just that simple. Now, some people may try to ignore your rights, or violate them, or pretend they don't exist. But they can't change the fact that they're yours. Human right number 30. No one can take away your human rights. What are human rights? Find out at youthforhumanrights.org.
All of you that are still with us, thank you so very much. We had an opportunity to share this on our Ayankba Network channel, as well as the Pope International channel on Facebook. And we shared it on multiple other groups and platforms. We do ask you to contact Pastor James if you want more information about how you can get access to youthforhumanrights.org videos, and also local materials that you can use in your organization or your community. This is Andrew Williams Jr. If you have any questions or comments, now's the time to ask before we close. The floor is open. With that, thank you everyone for joining us today. We're going to end this presentation and we look forward to seeing you in the future.
Thank you too. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Thank you, Andrew.
Thank you, Andrew. Wonderful. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you.